But you know, I've decided to put the message from 1 John on pause. We'll do it next week. We were here to hear some things this morning that we needed to hear. But I'm going to not open the scriptures because we are a people of the book. Psalm 1, please turn there this morning. And how can we not open the book when we heard so much about how those people were so grateful to have it in their own language? Psalm 1 says, "Blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the wicked, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of scoffers, but his delight is in the law of the Lord. And on his law he meditates day and night. He is like a tree planted by streams of water that yields its fruit in its season, and its leaf, it does not wither. In all that he does, he prospers. The wicked are not so, but are like chaff that the wind drives away. Therefore, the wicked will not stand in judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked will perish." Let's pray. Heavenly Father, as we take a few minutes in your word this morning, we are grateful that the promises of your scripture, that every tongue, tribe, and nation will be in heaven, are being fulfilled before our very eyes. Father, because of the faithful ministry of many, the gospel has gone to people who have not had it in their language. Father, what a joy. We rejoice because you have loved us so much that you saved us and then you sent missionaries to learn languages and to share the gospel with people, that they might be free from the bondage of their sin. Now, as we look at your word, may we rejoice in the truth of it. In Jesus' name, amen. I was sitting there looking at the clock thinking, this is going to be tough to do a 35-minute message. And I said, Lord, I just want to share something from the word. And I'm not into mystical experiences, but I was like, I think I want to share from Psalm 1. And, you know, it really talks about the tree being planted by the stream of water. And just as I was asking the Lord if I should share that, a shadow of a tree came up right along the wall there. And I'm not saying, hey, live your life that way. Do not. But I smiled. I would say make your decisions based not on just shadows, FYI. This is a Psalm of David. It's a Psalm of David that is an introduction to the entire book. So really, it's calling on us to read the entirety of the Psalms and how we're to approach this. And one of the things it says is, this is what a blessed person is like. A person who has a blessedness to them, that they are enjoying the privileges of God, that they are in God's favor, that they are enjoying a spiritual, vitally spiritual life. Blessed is the man who walks not, and what is the warning? In the counsel of the wicked, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of scoffers. Now you see that there's something going on here in this passage that I think is very critical. And that's that you do not become hardened against God's word instantaneously. There's a progression of the hardening of the heart. First, the person walks in the counsel of the wicked. When you listen to things that you ought not to, when you listen to the voices that lead you away from God instead of to God, you are walking in the counsel of the wicked. And it's real and it's everywhere. The voices are saying, don't put your faith in this outdated book, even though it's alive and relevant, as we know. It tells you, the voices in the world, they say, what can possibly be in here? We are so progressive. We are so wise in our own eyes. And when we listen to those voices, just pursue the things that are important to you, that you want to do to fulfill your life in this world on a material plane, we are walking in the counsel of the wicked. We're walking with them. And what are we doing when we walk? We're walking further away from God. But then it says, the person becomes more entrenched. They've walked, now they're gonna take a stand. But the stand is not a good one. The stand is a standing in the way of sinners. You've walked in the counsel of the wicked, and now you're going to take your stand. But it's on the wrong side. Because standing in the way of sinners is guaranteed condemnation. We'll come back to that in a minute. But it means you're saying, I will reject the things of God and live like the world. And I'm taking a stand because this is not accidental, it's intentional. And not only will you stand in the way of sinners, but you finally entrench yourself and you sit down in the seat of scoffers. And you move not only from listening to wicked advice to practicing wicked advice, now you mock God and His word. You doubt its power. And believe me, even people who go to church are vulnerable to this. There's only one solution, and it's the next thing. Blessed is the man who doesn't do those things, right? What do they do instead? They delight in the law of the Lord, His word, and they meditate on it day and night. I cannot emphasize this enough. One of the reasons that we as Christians feel so weak in our lives sometimes is because we're not spending time in the word. Look, we make all kinds of excuses. I'm too busy. I got a lot going on. Ooh, I just don't have. Are you telling me you do not have the time? You can tell me that. But God is not fooled by this. We make time for what is important. But it's not just a guilt trip. It's not like, oh, feel bad, therefore I'm in the Word. It says His delight is in the law of the Lord. That means He loves the Word. He wants to be in the Word. And He's thinking about it day and night because it is enrichment for their soul. And this is important for us to understand. The book of Joshua says, you know, to meditate on it, and then you will find success. And I like what it says in verse 3, because this picture is so healthy. He is like the person who meditates on God's word, is like a tree planted by streams of water. Now, a tree that doesn't get moisture dries out and dies. I can remember when I was in cadets, I went to the summer camp, and as you can see, I'm obviously physically, I've got prowess like you wouldn't believe, you know. I was drafted into the military, I think. Just they looked at me and they said, Rambo, right? I don't understand why you guys are laughing, but anyway. So I go to this camp, and each week, it's just brutal for me. We're out in the hot sun. We're marching. I mean, I lost a lot of weight. But at one point, about halfway through, I got really sick. And I didn't want to tell anybody, because back in those days, they would have called you a big wuss, and they would have laughed at you if you were feeling weak. So I kept quiet, but every day I could feel myself getting worse and worse. And I went on this march and over this dune, and I passed out in the dune. And the way it was situated, I fell between two dunes. Nobody knew I was missing. When I woke up, nobody was around. What happened? But can I say that one of the reasons that maybe we do not feel spiritually vital is because we're weakening ourselves. And we every day, and we don't do anything about it. We don't talk to our brothers and sisters. We don't reach out. We don't get into God's word. And guess what happens? We weaken and we weaken and we weaken. And then all of a sudden, we're angry and bitter at God because God isn't doing what we want him to do. But the reality is, we haven't been spending time with him in his word. And we're not like that tree. That tree planted by the water, it bears fruit. You know, it bears fruit in the tough season. Its leaves do not wither. Oftentimes, one of the reasons we wither is because we're not spending enough time with God. Look, can I tell you, you don't need to have everything together to go into God's word. It's actually a great place to be. Read the Psalms. David certainly didn't. In all that the person who spends time with God, he does, he prospers. That's not talking about money. Their life is good whether they have money or not. Their life is good whether they have cancer or not because they have God. It doesn't mean that they're in easy situations. But you know, here's what I'll say. The sad thing is people choose to not be in God's word. People choose to listen to the mockers, the scorners, the scoffers, the sinners. And what happens? They are the wicked. Those who reject God and his word, which in essence is rejecting Jesus Christ as your Savior. Because that's what the scriptures call us to do, is to repent and believe in Jesus. The wicked are not so. They are like the chaff that the wind drives away. Now, chaff. If you've ever been on a farm with a pitchfork, you know, being a country boy, I've got to do this. Grain. When you toss it up in the air, there's these little fine fibers that fly off. That's chaff. And when you throw it up, the wind, just the gentlest wind, moves it away. Without Christ, that is you before God. You will not stand against his judgment. You are like helpless chaff, blown away on the wind. They cannot stand in judgment. And the sinners will not be in the congregation of the righteous. Here's the reality. We saw this video of these people in the Philippines, and they're receiving the New Testament in their language, which is amazing. Praise God for that. But each one of those people need to personally repent and believe in Jesus. And we need to personally repent and believe in Jesus. Because you will not go to heaven without Jesus. You cannot stand in the congregation of the righteous in heaven. When it says every tongue, tribe, and nation will be there, I plead with you, brothers and sisters, that you will be there too. Sometimes because of the fact that we have such a beautiful truth of having such a rich heritage of Christianity, we take it for granted. And this is what I thought about with this message, and I wrap up here. They were receiving the word with great joy. They didn't even have the option several years ago to read the word in their language. Oh, that we wouldn't just take it for granted, because we have it. We have it. And we are blessed. Well, let me say this. Don't worry about what the world throws at you. Don't worry about the fact that the voices are loud and frustrating sometimes, because the Lord, Yahweh, knows the way of the righteous. He will keep you if you know Christ. But the way of the wicked will perish. There's no neutrality. You will either live a blessed life or a condemned life. And through Christ, we live a blessed life. Praise his name. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you that this psalm is here to remind us that we are blessed when we walk in your ways and meditate on your word, O God. I thank you for this morning, for the privilege of everything that we have gotten to experience. I thank you that we have your word and that we will not take it for granted. Help us to live it and to know it. to spend time in it, to meditate upon it day and night. Father, we pray that the gospel work in the Philippines would continue, and we are praying specifically that the Old Testament translation would be expedited, that obstacles would be removed, that they would have the privilege of reading the Old Testament in this specific language. Father, as we go to this barbecue now in this time of fellowship, may we rejoice. May we not give one another wicked counsel, but righteous counsel and encouragement in fellowship. I thank you for those who have prepared the meal. I thank you for this body, and I thank you for the greens this morning. But most of all, none of this would happen unless, Father, you had first loved us and sent your Son, Jesus. And so we thank you for Jesus Christ, our great Savior, and in his name we pray. Amen.